ओके, आली वर्सेस फिक्स्ड प्राइस फ्रीलांस प्रोजेक्ट्स, इज देयर अ पर्टिकुलर रीजन टू चूज वन ओवर द अदर? एज फार एज माई एक्सपीरियंस इज कंसर्न्ड, देयर इज नो पर्टिकुलर रीजन एज सच फॉर विच यू रियली नीड टू चूज वन ओवर द अदर. आई पर्सनली फील दैट वेदर इट्स फिक्स्ड प्राइस और आली, बोथ यू नो अरेंजमेंट्स कैन वर्क प्रिटी फाइन. The reason problems arise with a lot of freelancers is because they do not follow the system. Let me try and explain. Both Elance and Odesk, you know, two of the major freelance platforms, the online freelance platforms today, they offer good payment protection systems as far as hourly jobs are concerned. So as long as you work within those systems, you're protected to the extent that the rate which has been pre-decided between you and the client, the hourly rate which has been fixed, you will be paid as long as you use the tracker, the software in question. Both Odesk and Elance have that. So do employ that when you're working on hourly projects. And if you do that, even if the client runs away with your work, Elance and Odesk will guarantee your payment. So as far as hourly projects are concerned, at least the payment protection is in place. As far as fixed price projects are concerned, Elance offers the escrow facility. So my recommendation, which is a very strict and strong recommendation, is that on Elance, whenever you work on fixed price projects, make sure that the escrow account of the project is funded first. Before you even start working, make sure that the escrow account is funded. Remember that, you know, there can be so many different situations which arise besides the possibility that the client runs away with your work. Imagine that the client dies and nobody else in the world knows about the project. You know, this is an example which I've quoted earlier as well as in my previous videos. But nonetheless, you know, this is a strong possibility which can arise, and there are various other possibilities as well. So none, you know, keeping all of that in mind, always make sure that the escrow account of the project is funded before. And even if you're working on, you know, a big project, let's say $1,000 plus project, you don't always have to compel the client to fund the complete escrow. I've always seen that, you know, whenever big projects are there, invariably, you know, there are certain portions in which you complete it. It's not like you complete the entire thing in one go. And you know, unfortunately, the way the online freelancing, you know, scenario works, it's as though, you know, $1,000 is a lot of money. In reality, it's not a lot of money. Even here in my own, you know, native country of India, where, you know, a lot of Westerners have this perception that, oh my God, you know, $1,000 is like some big bounty, you know, and I'll be able to live for months, maybe years, you know, on that. It's nothing like that. You know, I can spend it in a day, I can spend it in an hour, I can even spend it in a minute. You know, if I buy some things or some things, you know, of that value, there are enough, you know, stuff going around for me to spend that money within no time. So, but having said that, you know, let's say you have a $1,000 project, say in writing and translation, you have X amount of content to create in maybe, you know, a software development project or, you know, coding project, you have, you know, this much of code to write or this kind of app to develop, whatever be the case. I've always seen that there are milestones which can be worked out. So in fixed price projects, what you should do is that, you know, create milestones that, okay, let's say I'm going to develop an app, you're an app developer, and for that, the first milestone can be like, okay, I'm going to develop this portion of the app. Or maybe there's something prior to that that I'm going to ideate, and I'm going to, you know, create these icons or this step or this part of the app development process I'm going to do at this stage, and this is the milestone, this is the amount that you're going to pay me for that. Then we'll go to step two, where you're going to do, you know, probably the next set of, you know, tasks. So accordingly, say step three, step four. So maybe, you know, $1,000 project can be broken down into four milestones of $250, and as you progress through those steps, you have the funds escrowed first, and then as you complete, then those funds are released to you. So make sure that when you work on fixed price projects on Elance, the escrow account of that project is funded first. And like I said, you don't have to have the entire project funded. You can always have milestones. And in addition to that, fixed price offers the possibility that you can always have certain milestones which are not only funded but also released to you in advance. You know, and this is actually a common practice which many freelancers and, you know, contractors around the world, they follow, wherein what they do is that, okay, we've agreed on a $1,000 project. You deposit, you know, $250 in advance, which is like a commitment from your side towards the project and towards me as the freelancer, and you release that amount as soon as you award the project to me. So, and the remaining 750, which can either be one milestone or three milestones, whatever, you know, as per your, you know, mutual comfort between you and the client, you work that out, and once that is done, and then you start working on the project. So you have, you know, that sort of flexibility is there, which these, you know, hourly projects do not offer. You know, so that's something. Now, coming back to the whole software or the tracker interface, you know, there are certain cons as well. One is they are very, you know, sort of interfering and overbearing. You know, that's the word which I would use. That they are overbearing in the sense there are screenshots taken of your, you know, the system as you're working. So those screenshots, you know, you might be working on your project, but, you know, in between you might just get a, you know, a pop on your Facebook and you want to, you know, just check it out. Some notification has come, something has come. And imagine that at that very moment a screenshot is taken. You know, so obviously the client will see, and later on, if there is any issue, even the concerned freelance platform, say Odesk or Elance, will see that, hey, this guy's supposed to be working on the project, but he's actually on Facebook. So, you know, those sort of situations arise. Plus, think about the privacy factor. We all, you know, appreciate privacy in our lives, and this sort of, you know, this screenshot taking interface is essentially an invasion of privacy. At least I look at it that way. Yes, you know, what else can we, you know, look at when the workers, you know, located remotely, the client is located elsewhere? How else does, you know, monitoring take place? In the current circumstances, you know, this is probably the best way in which, you know, monitoring of those allotted hours can actually take place. But it is intrusive. So that's something which you do need to think about. And now let me, you know, describe to you an experience where the client actually, you know, did not pay. I did follow the system, and then eventually I did get paid. You know, the online platform in question was Elance, and this is the one and only time in which it happened to me, where, you know, I duly delivered the work. I followed the entire, you know, Ali thing, the process where I had the tracker in place. The tracker was taking screenshots, and I was continuously working only on the project and nothing else. So, you know, I played by the rules, and then the client, you know, still did not pay me and, you know, ran away. I eventually did get paid, but then that whole, you know, process took a lot of time. So that's again, which you know, something which you need to think about. You know, that even if you've played by the rules, done everything which you need to do to, you know, honestly work as per the number of hours allotted, and then the client turns out to be a scoundrel, a scamster, then eventually, even if you do get paid by the platform, that might take a lot of time because they're going to investigate, they'll, you know, review the screenshots, and they'll review the work that you've, you know, delivered. And based on that, they'll ensure that you're paid even if the client did not pay you. So, you know, keep that in mind, that it might take a lot of time for you to eventually get, you know, paid. Another thing which you need to keep in mind is that, you know, this whole system of hourly allocation, it is, you know, subject to client revision even in between. So suppose, you know, an hour a week has a certain number of hours which have been allotted. Midweek also, what I've noticed is that, especially on Odesk, that the client can actually go ahead and, you know, change the number of hours, you know, modify the number of hours allotted. And what can happen is that you have, you know, planned your time accordingly. You've probably even, you know, already worked those number of hours, but the, you know, because the midway the number of hours allotted have been modified, there may not be a possibility for you to, you know, go back. Unless, again, you know, as per the tracker system, and you go back and you say that, no, these hours were already allotted to me, I already worked on those hours, and then, you know, I need to be paid even if the client has, you know, changed things midway. So that's something which you need to think about. As far as the lucrativeness, if there's a word like that, of Ali projects, let me take Ali projects first as concerned. At times, they can be quite lucrative. You know, what I have seen is that, you know, I have a certain number of hours, you know, allotted to me. And I know that in all probability, it will take that much time at the maximum or less. But, you know, I do end up getting paid a reasonable amount, which in a fixed price scenario might have, you know, given me less. But because I have, you know, been the client has agreed to my quote of, say, 5 hours or 6 hours, whatever. And then, you know, per hour, thanks to the number of hours which have been allotted, let's say that I quote 6 hours, $25 an hour. So that comes to 150. And whereas if I had quoted a fixed price of 150, the client might have thought, no, that's seems to be a lot. But then, you know, I say that, no, this will take 6 hours and I'm going to work dedicatedly, you know, for those 6 hours, and $25 is a nominal sum to pay. So then I do get paid for something which, you know, is probably a reasonable amount of effort without being a spectacular amount of effort. So, you know, that's something which, you know, as far as the lucrativeness is concerned, Ali projects can also prove to be quite lucrative. And over time, in case of Ali projects, what I've seen, you know, what happens is that clients tend to trust you to the extent that, you know, you don't always need to have this whole tracker thing. Though for protection purposes, like I've always said, you should follow that. You should, if you're working on Ali projects, try and make sure that, you know, you have, you know, you use that software. But I've also seen that, say, when you're working with companies and not necessarily with individuals, where the billing system is, you know, relatively automated to quite an extent, you're assured of your payment, you know, so you don't always need to have that tracker in place. And irrespective of the, you know, real number of hours that you worked, you have a certain, you know, system in place where, you know, you are going to be paid for these X number of hours each week, every week, week after week. You know, so that's another arrangement which does work well, I would say. Now, as far as, you know, fixed price arrangement is concerned, I would say that sometimes it does prove, you know, non-lucrative as well, in the sense that, you know, you have committed to this price and, you know, the client has said that, okay, this is the maximum that I can pay, or this is the amount that I'm willing to pay, and I'm not willing to pay beyond that. So, you know, you might see that, oh, I agreed to this price, but, you know, as it has turned out, you know, I've actually, it's not worth the, you know, amount of time and effort which I've spent. I probably spend more time, more effort, but I've only been paid this much. So this is something, that's why I always stress that when it comes to fixed price projects, try and think through things, as you know, in a visionary way as possible, that, okay, no, this is, you know, this is something which I'm quoting, but is this realistic or is it not realistic? You know, that's something which you need to think about. If you see that it is not realistic, then you need to work accordingly, that no, either, you know, you discuss with the client that, though, no, this is not realistic, I need to, you know, we need to increase the budget. Or, you know, you probably decline the project, you know, and as a freelancer, always be free to, you know, decline projects as well. You know, you have the freedom. That's why you're a freelancer. You have the freedom to not just choose the projects you want to work with, but even more the projects and the clients that you don't want to work with or should not be working with. You know, that's something, that's a bigger decision which often needs to be taken. And unfortunately, many freelancers don't take that decision. They think that, oh my God, it's a privilege that, you know, I'm getting this job. But then, is it really worth your time? Is it really worth your education? Is it really worth your background? A lot of these things you need to think about. You can't always be, you know, just any work which comes in and I'll take it and I'll deliver it. Whatever it pays me, I'll just feel privileged. That is a wrong attitude. So, you know, that's something which you need to keep in mind. A final point which I'll make is that, you know, when it comes to fixed price projects versus Ali projects, one thing which I've noticed is that in the case of the former, which is the fixed price arrangement, discipline often goes out of the window. That, okay, I have 3 days or 5 days or 1 week, whatever, to, for this, say, I don't know, $100 or $200 project. Somehow, you know, that old Murphy's law that, you know, time stretches to fill the work available, or work stretches to fill the time available. That's the correct one. So, you know, that happens wherein you take your own sweet time, you work as a laggard, and then, you know, you don't work in a disciplined way. Whereas in case of hourly projects, and especially when you're using the tracker, and mind you know, when you're using the tracker, please be disciplined. You know, try to avoid doing other things. Try to avoid, you know, these intrusions. Try and have your own little space in which you work, where you're not disturbed by phone calls, by, you know, other correspondence, people in your home. Try and, you know, have this, if you're working from home, you know, try and have this home office arrangement, which is, you know, completely non-intrusive, you know, to other elements and, you know, things which can affect your ability to focus on the work. Try and, you know, close all your social media, close, switch off the television, music. Some people, you know, work good with music. I don't know, but by and large, I don't. You know, when I'm working, I prefer a, you know, quiet ambience that works best for me. But, you know, from the discipline point of view, I would say that sometimes, especially if you're using the tracker, you know, hourly projects are better because you complete that, you know that, oh, I have these number of hours which have been allotted to me. I need to finish that work within those number of hours and get paid accordingly. Whereas in a fixed price scenario, like I said, you know, that work stretches to fill the time available. So I have 5 days, so I'll take my own sweet time to, you know, complete the project. So that's something which, you know, does not happen, and again, which you need to keep in mind. So in conclusion, as I've, you know, said so many different things about hourly versus fixed price, you know, freelance projects. In conclusion, you know, to the end, what, and this is based on my observation, that a lot of people tend to demonize, you know, hourly projects. Don't do that. You know, don't have this attitude that, oh my God, you know, hourly projects are an absolute no-no and I must avoid them like the plague. You know, just completely stay away from them. Don't have that attitude. That's a wrong attitude. You know, just play by the rules. That's something which I would say. And also, I would say that, you know, assess your clients well. This is something which, unfortunately, a lot of freelancers, especially new ones, they don't do. You know, they simply don't assess their clients properly. Look at their work history. Look at their, you know, payment history. Look at the kind of work that they've done. Look at the kind of feedback that freelancers have left for them. These are very important factors, you know. You should always research your clients. You know, don't just, yes, today, you know, given the circumstances where there are a lot of projects and a lot of freelancers, you know, vying for those projects, and the number of bids, you know, be having to be put in has also, you know, gone up, wherein a lot of freelancers don't invest that kind of time which is, you know, ideally required to be invested to, you know, gauge clients, to vet their, you know, actual credibility. But you should ideally do that, you know, spend those few moments. It doesn't take a lot of time and effort, you know, glancing over client profiles, their pages, and, you know, seeing the kind of feedback that they've received, the kind of payment that they've made. However much these platforms are trying to keep things hidden, but I still feel that if you do your due diligence, it is not so difficult to see that, you know, how well these clients stand, where they stand, what kind of payments that they made, etc., etc. So it is possible. So do your due diligence, and if you do that, you know, you should be able to, you know, work out things well, irrespective of the scenario, whether it is an hourly arrangement or a fixed price one. But keep all of the different things that I've, you know, mentioned in this video in mind. In the end, eventually, I'm sure you'll be able to make a prudent choice and not have any extreme, you know, sort of an opinion that, oh, I'll do only this or I'll do only that. You know, choose optimally and play by the rules. I'm sure, you know, you will not be scammed, and irrespective of the path that you take, you will eventually be blessed with the financial rewards or the satisfaction from, you know, project completion, whatever motivates you. Cheers.